Have you ever thought about turning a regular butane torch into a soldering iron? In this video, we'll walk you through the simple DIY process using easy-to-find materials. With some creativity, you can make your own handy welder that's perfect for small electronics projects. Stick around for useful tips, step-by-step guidance, and real testing. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more fun DIY ideas. First, let's start by carefully removing the outer casing of the butane torch head. This step will give us access to the internal parts, making it easier to modify and attach the components we need. Be gentle while taking it apart to avoid damaging the nozzle or the fuel system. As we remove the parts, it's a good idea to keep a small cup nearby to collect all the screws. This way, they won't get lost during the process, and everything will be neatly organized for reassembly later. Inside the torch head, you'll find a compact setup consisting of a nozzle, a small gas valve, and the ignition system. Despite its small size, the structure is quite sturdy and designed to handle heat efficiently. Next, I'll remove this front section so I can feed the electrical wire through. This step will make it easier to connect the wire securely and prepare the torch for its new function as a mini welder. Here, I'll use a small copper tube. It's just the right size to serve as a holder for the welding tip, keeping it steady and well-aligned during use. Now, I'm going to redesign this part, adjusting the setup so it fits better and works more efficiently for our mini welding tool. I'll cut a small piece, about 4 centimeters long, to use for this part of the build. Using pliers, I'll lightly cut around the tube to create a groove, then bend it to break it off. If I cut it all the way through at once, the end would flatten and become blocked. Now I need to attach the copper tube to the torch head, but it seems slightly too large. So I'll grind it down a little to make sure it fits snugly. After carefully sanding it down, the copper tube now slides perfectly into the torch head. This tight fit will keep it stable and prevent any wobbling when we use it as a mini welder. With the tube secured firmly in place, it ensures both durability and safety during operation. With the copper tube securely in place, it's time to move on to the wiring, the heart of this DIY mini welder. I'll be using 2 flexible wires, one for positive and one for negative. First, I'll strip the ends of each wire. You can adjust the temperature yourself by changing the wiring or adding a resistor. It's super flexible for small welding tasks. Next, I'll thread the electrical wire to the copper tube and guide it all the way down. This step helps position the wire neatly inside, ready for connection to the welding tip. Next, I'll solder some tin onto the tip of the wire to make it slightly larger. This will improve contact and allow electricity to flow more effectively to the welding tip. Now I'll reassemble the parts of the torch head, carefully putting everything back into place. This step ensures the copper tube and wire stay firmly secured, while keeping the original structure intact for safe use. Once reassembled, the head feels solid and neatly fitted, giving confidence that it's ready for the next steps. I'll drill a small hole at the tip of the copper tube. I'll place a small screw here, so that when I insert the welding tip, I can tighten the screw to hold it firmly in place. This will keep the tip steady and prevent it from slipping during use. I've got quite a few old batteries lying around, perfect for experimenting with this mini welding setup. Instead of throwing away, I'm going to repurpose the inner core of the battery and turn it into a soldering tip, a clever way to give new life to old materials. I'll carefully extract the inner core from one of these old batteries. This core is usually made from conductive metal, and its size makes it perfect for precise soldering tasks. When doing this, it's important to be cautious, avoid touching any leaky material, and always work in a well-ventilated area. Once the casing is removed, I'll trim and shape the core to fit our terminal block connection. It's a great way to recycle and repurpose parts that would otherwise go to waste. Next, I'll grind the battery core to shape it into a fine soldering tip. This will help it heat up evenly and work more precisely. Now that it's been ground to the right shape, the core fits snugly into the copper tube. And just like that, we've turned it into a working welding tip. Now I'll insert the battery core into the copper tube, making sure it fits tightly. After that, I'll secure it with a screw so the welding tip stays firmly in place, ready for use. Once tightened, it feels solid and stable, giving confidence that the tip won't move during welding. To complete the wiring, I'll attach an alligator clip to the other end. It makes the connection quick, secure, and easy to detach when needed. I'll add another wire to connect from the negative terminal. This will complete the circuit and allow current to flow properly through the soldering tip. For this wire, I'll attach alligator clips to both ends. That way, it's easy to connect and disconnect from both the power source and the device. The alligator clips act as flexible terminals. They grip tightly onto wires, battery terminals, or metal parts, making it easy to test and adjust connections during prototyping. Plus, they save time by eliminating the need for permanent joints. With everything secured, it's time to test a welding tip. I'll power it up and try it on a small piece of metal. For the power source, I'll be using a standard motorcycle battery. It's a 12V lead acid battery, powerful enough to heat up the soldering tip and stable for small electronics work. This type of battery is easy to find, rechargeable, and delivers consistent current, which makes it perfect for our DIY soldering project. Now it's time to put our DIY soldering tool to the test. The tip heats quickly and transfers energy well, proving that it's firmly attached and ready for real use. For the test, I'll weld a small screw onto a utility knife blade. As the tip touches a metal surface, it delivers enough heat to bond the screw securely to the blade, showing the welder's strength on real materials. After cooling down, the screw holds firmly onto the blade. The joint feels solid and doesn't wobble, proving that the weld is strong and reliable. I'll begin by trying to solder onto this razor blade, which is thin and metallic, making it a good challenge for the tool. As I bring the soldering tip to the joint, the solder begins to melt and flow smoothly onto the razor blade and the stripped wire. The tin spreads evenly, bonding the wire to the metal surface in a single, shiny solder joint. After just a few seconds, it cools and solidifies, creating a strong, clean connection between the wire and the razor blade. After soldering the two razor blades together, the joint feels surprisingly strong. Even when applying pressure or flexing slightly, the blades stay firmly connected without any signs of separation. The solder has bonded well to the thin metal surfaces, creating a solid bridge between them. In conclusion, by repurposing a simple butane torch and a few easy-to-find materials, we've created a compact DIY welding tool. It's sturdy, practical, and works well for small projects. This experiment shows that with a bit of creativity, you can build useful tools right at home.